Yeah, and welcome, welcome, welcome to Papa Stash Pop. So this one's hot off the press, or, you know, kind of hot off the press. It's on the chart, which brings me to what we do here at Papa Stash Pop, whether it's pop, rock, country, R&B, whatever. We kind of hit all the tunes that are chart bound. Now, that doesn't mean we can't request songs that aren't, you know, like top 100 or whatever. I aim to please, but this is a request zone down here, but today it is a strum zone. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take you beginners to beginner intermediates out there and teach you how to strum better. Now that video is not on YouTube, so make sure you click the link below. It'll teach you how to count, rhythm, how to do, you know, downstrokes, upstrokes, how to put them together, how to create patterns so you too can be a songwriter. And then I'll be teaching your song, which would be awesome. So anyways, let's zoom in for a closer look and learn this tune. All right, so let's go over the intro. Here we go. Okay, so right off the bat, we're gonna have a capo on our first fret, and then I'm gonna refer to frets 1, 2, 3, 4. And then something else you might need is a box of tissues, because this song's really sad. And if you're not old enough to drink, you know, just substitute it for, like, you know, apple juice or fruit punch or something. Have a fruit punch. Doesn't quite have the same effect, but that's okay. So what we're going to do is kind of a hybrid G/D chord. So just go ahead and pretend that you're going to do a G chord. Okay. Now our first finger, we're gonna go right down on the second fret G like it would be a D chord. So now we're set up like a D chord down here where we have second fret G, third fret B. Now, I'm gonna pick from the E to the B, but this finger right here is muting out that A string. Now we got a floating finger, which we are going to utilize, and we're gonna hammer on to the fourth fret, so you get. Okay? Now, something to work on is making sure that's rounded, and it's something I'm working on too, because the, you know, the tendency is to hammer it on like this, and it mutes out that B string, so make sure you're right on your tip. Okay? Now, the strum pattern, I'm gonna go down and do my hammer right there, and then I'm gonna go down, up, down, so we got. Okay? Now after that, then I'm gonna go. So it's basically gonna be down, up, downs. And then I'm gonna take my pinky off on the last one. So we got. Then I'm gonna just take this finger, right, and you can end that on an upstroke or a downstroke, whatever's comfortable for you. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that same riff, but now we're just gonna change our root note down to what would be C, an open position. In this case, it's C sharp, but three frets, right? Now we're gonna change it up, and we're just gonna go to the D string. Now this time, getting into the D string, what we're gonna do is we're gonna hammer on. Okay? Now, so you've hammered on. So I'm gonna go down, up, down, down, up. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hammer on with my pinky. Okay, just like we did before. And then I'm gonna go take my fingers off of the G string altogether. And then come to the D string, fourth fret. So we got. Okay, now you can do that however you want. For me, it's easier to catch those two on an upstroke. And then we're going to go straight into a C9 chord. So the first hit's going to be with the first finger on, then you're going to take it off, and then you're going to hammer on. Okay, so. And then that gets us into the verse. So. Again. And then into the actual verse. So, if we do that all together. That brings us into the verse, so let's go over that. Now the verse is just simple open chords as well. We're going to do the same chords that we've been using, but now more traditional forms. So we got the G, C add 9, D, and then we're going to go back to C add 9. So it's going to sound like this. So the strum pattern is basically the rhythm's gonna go. Right? Just a real easy flowing strum pattern. Down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up. Something to that effect. Now we're going to do the same kind of thing with the C9, where we're playing with putting our first finger on and off the D string second fret. It's not an exact pattern, right? We can do it sometimes, we can leave it off. If you're just kind of new to guitar, go ahead and leave it on and don't even worry about it. But if you listen to the actual track, they're kind of doing some interplay with this finger. So just kind of play with it, you know, make your own way, right? Blaze your own trail, but you'll hear it in the track. So you can figure out what it's doing if you want to be precise. All right, so we got. Into the chorus. So let's go over the chorus. Okay, so if you notice, we ended with the intro, but before that, we're gonna add one chord to our progression, and that's gonna be an E minor. Okay, so the progression is gonna go G, D, E minor, C, G, and then we're gonna let it ring out on D, two, three, four, intro, and then that'll get you back into the verse. So, same kind of thing, nice strummy strum pattern. Something like that. Okay, so, and then you go into the intro. Now, the second time through all of this stuff, where we had the hold on the verse in the beginning on the C add 9, the 4 count, 2, 3, 4 chorus, we're going to strum through it this time. And then we're going to do the same thing on the chorus. So on that D where we'd normally hold, we're going to strum that as well. Now, that will get you into a bridge. So, let me demonstrate what the second chorus is like going into the bridge. If you notice, I just added 2 G's at the end, the full strum pattern. And someone's so excited they wanted to call me and like, dude, what is that progression? Don't forget to turn off your cell phone when you're filming. All right, so anyways, the bridge goes like this. Back into the actual chorus part. And then what it does is, at the end of that chorus part, and don't worry, I'll review the bridge. After the chorus, it just goes back and forth between G and C at night. So the bridge, C add 9, D, and then you're gonna do, so it's just like the normal strum pattern we've been doing. Now on the E minor, I'm just gonna go down, down, up, down, down, up. And then the same thing on the D, down, down, up, down, down, up, and then into the C. Way to go. Now don't forget the link below. There's always a link down there. This time it's the strum link. Sometimes it's the song request link. All that different stuff. But always check down there below in the description part. There is always some sort of a link that you can click on. Sometimes there are videos that aren't on YouTube. All that kind of stuff. Strum video 2 is on its way, so that'll be out soon. So remember the goal here, Papa Stash Pop. Big, happy guitar playing music, loving family worldwide. Our brothers and sisters here, there, over there, across the waters. Let's drop songs on each other and have a good time. And we'll do just a worldwide jam and have a good time together. Have fun and play some music, because that's awesome. All right, you guys, thanks so much for the support. You guys are awesome as always. I'll catch you next time.